Hello, today I'm going to show you how to get Tetris running on your LED matrix, and not only that, but how you can also control it via Bluetooth from your phone. This leads on from a project I started a couple of months back now using ESP32, and if you haven't seen that video, I'll leave a link in the description, and if I can, I'll put a little card up above here as well. So now you've seen what it looks like and how bad I am at Tetris, let's get started. So I'm going to talk you through now how to install this the software to make this work if you want to replicate what I've done here. And if you've never used the ESP32 board before in the Arduino IDE, I recommend this tutorial from randomnerdtutorials.com. There's a link to this in the description below, and this will show you how to quickly and easily get the ESP32 set up in the Arduino IDE environment. Now, the software, the Tetris software, is very heavily based on an example by this chap, by Aaron Liddiment. And again, there's a link to this GitHub in the description below. And he's created a series of libraries for FastLED. So you've got LED text, LED matrix, and LED sprites are the ones that we're going to actually use. So we're going to download each one of those. So if we just go into each one, we've got LED matrix there, for example. And we can click on kernel download. You can download it as a zip file. And you want to do the same for LED text and LED sprites. And then you want to put them in your normal Arduino libraries folder. The next thing you're going to want to do is download the INO file. Now, as I say, this is originally written by this chap, by Aaron Liddiment, but I've altered it quite a bit. So instead of working on button presses, it actually works over Bluetooth instead. And I'll show you how to set that up in a minute. So you should have the INO file. Looks something like this. Now, the thing is, if we've got our libraries installed, the three different libraries, and we've got the Tetris INO file here, if I hit compile on this, you'll notice that it will actually throw up a few errors. So let's give this a few seconds to sort itself out. And the errors are related to the fact that the max and min functions in the ESP32 library have actually changed. So previously, you could put into that function, you could mix types. So in some of this code, you get ints and uints mixed together in min-max code. And what happens there is that it throws some errors. So let's have a look at the error log, or the output log down here. And you'll see, let's scroll through to here. Here you go. So it says M frame equals max M num frames minus one frame. And the issue is, it says there's no matching function for call to max int uint 8t. So to fix that problem, all we need to do is go to Arduino libraries folder, and where you've got LED sprites master, if we go into there and we load up the LED sprites.cpp. If we search for, let's look for max open brackets, and you can see there's a function max open brackets, blah, 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 whatever's inside there. Now we need to change that. Instead of using the ESP32 version of this, we need to use the original Arduino version of this instead. So what we're going to do is we're going to replace that with underscore max open brackets everywhere we find that in ledsprites.cpp. So let's hit replace all on that. And it says three occurrences were replaced. And it's exactly the same with min as well. So if we to min, hit replace all, and two of those occurrences were replaced. So we're going to save that file, go back to our Arduino file, and if we try and compile it this time, hopefully it should compile without any errors. And that took a few seconds, but you can see there that it has compiled happily. Now with the Bluetooth control, you have two different options. I have linked the APAC file in below, so you can simply download that and sideload it onto your Android device. If you don't want to do that, I've also included the AIA file, which is an MIT App Inventor file. So if you want to have a look at how this works, or if you want to change how this works, nice and easy to do. You go to MIT App Inventor and sign in, or sign up for a new account. Go to projects, import.aia from my computer, and it should appear here. And then you can muck about with it from here. You can change whatever you like. You can change the code. You can change the pictures that appear on here. It's a little bit beyond the scope of this video. So if this is something you'd like to do, there are plenty of App Inventor tutorials online that you can do that with. Once you're happy with it, if you click on build, and you can click app, and you can simply save the APK to your computer, and then you can sideload it onto your Arduino device as before. So I think that's everything software-wise. All we have to do now is upload the sketch to our ESP32, find the APAC on your phone, and connect to the Bluetooth.
First time you do this, you'll have to pair your phone with the Bluetooth module on the ESP32. So I'm just going to press scan here. Hopefully what we're looking for is ESP32 Tetris. If I just scroll down here, there it is, ESP32 Tetris. It says pairing, and it's done. Okay, at this point, we're then going to open up the Bluetooth app that we sideloaded earlier. Looks something like this. Let's press scan. And again, we're looking for ESP32 Tetris, which is this one just here. And hopefully we should be connected. So let's set this camera up properly and we'll have a play. Let's have a little play with this and you can watch and see how terrible I am at playing Tetris. Yep, I think the phrase is more practice is required. That's all I've got for today. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below. Thank you very much, and I'll see you next time.